Hey, buddy, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eat and Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance Series. Happy Monday, Mosh Pit. Hope your weekends were awesome. I had a fun weekend playing Pokemon Scarlet and all kinds of fun stuff. I mean, I've aired some grievances about the game, but I'm sure we'll get into that during this run here. But yeah, I hope everyone's weekend has gone off great and you're enjoying the cool weather, or you're just enjoying the weather, or you're just having a great start to your brand new week here. Thank you very much for being here. I appreciate all the support. Here's your meme of the day. This now, I got to say that this one's not that Sabad doesn't do great memes, but this one did get a really good lol out of me. Just because, like, it embodies like a yeah, of course, right? Sent here by Sabat 1727. Title thread was the gambling experience. Invicta takes blind items for once. Epic fetus. Good day, gentlemen. I am here to change the future. yeah. Epic fetus is just kind of like, you know. And I mean, if we needed any more like reason to not take blind items, well, there you go. The day is going to be 7, Lima 390. We've got great damage, thanks to us starting with the mark. Also, Blessed Penny and Mr. Mizzle. Kidding me? What is going on here? Mr. Me is going to help us out and get us this tarot card, which is going to give us the Fool. All right. But horrible, not horrible, actually. I actually take that back. We have no bad stats. No bad stats at all. Even our shot speed and tears rate are great. We have positive luck. Oh my goodness, what a start to Monday here. We get a soul heart too, I tell you what. So the Blessed Penny is going to give us a 30% chance to give us a half soul heart whenever we pick up a coin. It's something, 17% chance, my bad. For us to get a half soul heart whenever we pick up a penny, which is honestly, given the volume of coins that we pick up, throughout a run, like that's a very good amount of HP that we just get passively. So I'm all down for that. And of course the mark giving us some nice movement speed and damage, but like our base stats must have been crazy even before the mark was taken into account, because 6.12, like the mark is good, but it ain't that good. You know what I'm saying? Mr. Me, of course, is a great spacebar item to help us out and hopefully take some store items this time around. Although I was told by the Mosh Pit the last time we attempted to take some store items that it's no longer works off of the positioning of Mr. Me. It's just a 50-50 shot. Apparently, Secret Room is not there, so... All right. The store. I wouldn't mind getting... This is where bombing the donation machine is actually fantastic for us, because of the fact that, A, we get to buy another soul heart, and B, because this has a chance to give us at least one, maybe two soul hearts. Or one half soul heart. All right. I mean, it's a 17%. It's not cumulative, you know. It's 17% chance to pick up, to create a half soul heart. It doesn't matter how many coins you drop. But obviously, I mean, the more coins you have, the better chance you get, at least theoretically anyway. But we all know how Sinvic Deluxe works, so, you know. We could and should try to get a full charge on Mr. Me before going into the Devil Deal here. Mainly because he can steal a Devil Deal item, I think. Unless they change that somehow, which, I mean, with Repentance, who knows these days. The range upgrade, hooray. We got a Rotten Heart, which I actually didn't mean to pick up, but... we can't undo it now unless we take damage, but if we take damage on the Rotten Heart, we are dead. Super dead, so... Unless we find, like, a Temperance Machine or something. And not that taking the Rotten Heart's a huge deal, obviously. I just didn't want to have... I'd rather have a half red heart there in case we do find a Temperance Machine. The flies that you get are fine. You know, it's a little bit of uncontrolled damage that Isaac has, but it's a small gripe. It's not that big of a deal. All right, so we're going to take Mr. Me, and we're going to go try to get the Devil Deal here. A super great start. Really, really good start here for a Monday, I tell you what. And thank you, everybody, for the feedback on, again, the thumbnails, the continued feedback. Yuki's been doing an awesome job with them. And, again, the question arose, is Yuki getting paid for them? Of course he is. He's doing a fantastic job for me. I would never dream of not paying for such amazing artwork. We get Mother Transformation right away. And, oh, baby. Free... a Thame, and we also get Gimpy. Man, We are poised to have a fun run here. All right. Got Thanksgiving coming up soon, and I'm looking forward to that. It's been a long, rough year for a lot of people, and to have a little bit of family time. Thanksgiving is one of my favorite holidays. I don't like that many holidays, but Thanksgiving is one of them because I get to see Mama Victa. We get to eat lots of good food. Ooh, Forget Me Now is tempting here. I'm going to go back and get the Soul Heart. I saw it drop from Gimpy right as we went into the curse room. There we go. So we essentially didn't... We gained a half Soul Heart going into that curse room. The reason why Forget Me Now is tempting here is mainly because of the fact that if we do get another XL floor, which we do have a tendency to see double XL floors these days, then that will give us a fresh set of floors there. You see a Thame just absolutely rock the world of everything. Yeah, combined with that freezing effect, too, from Mom's Contact. Oh, man. New Thame is real, real good, y'all. It's really, really strong. The coupon along with Birthright. Obviously, we're going to be taking Birthright here. We should go back. There's no reason for us not to be getting charges on Mr. Me right now. And, I mean, who knows? I'm going to be lazy, by the way. Who knows? Maybe we'll stick with Mr. Me. You know, Mr. Me can be useful. Getting you items that you wouldn't have access to. Opening doors that you normally wouldn't be able to. Like that, all that stuff is really, really strong. And you never know, like that Soul Heart right there and the black Soul Heart that we have. You never know how one single move is going to evolve the way that your run is going. This one Soul Heart may not be that big of a deal, but you never know. This allows us to take a double deal. Thank you, Mr. Mizzle. Unfortunately, we don't have a key to get into the item room, so should have probably thought about that before using our charge there, but maybe we'll find a key. I think there was a key in the shop, but obviously we were going for Birthright first. We could also try to save Mr. Me for the shop, but again, that's only a 50-50 chance, so I think our first hit of damage here today. Movement speed is a little bit low, but I mean, that's such a nitpicky argument, a nitpicky reason to complain about something. Like, it's our HP or our movement speed is just fine. Just playing devil's advocate, you're trying to find it, like something that I could be like, well, we could improve a little bit on, We get ourselves a Yave, so now it's a moot point. But we are not going to be able to use Mr. Me here, so. See doodle. Yeah, we get two keys anyway, so. Good. And a half Soul Heart to boot, I tell you what. You're looking A-okay, Mr. Mizzle. Let's go check out the item room first, and then we'll double back and go into the store and grab Birthright before we go fight the boss. Usually a tinted rock in here. I don't see one today. Best bud. Birthright's going to give us three random items, and yeah. Hey, we got to go Worm Buddy, right? You got to go Worm Buddy. Come on now, we got to go Worm Buddy. Mr. Mega's not bad either, but we don't need the bombs. Had we needed the bombs, I would have definitely considered Mr. Mega. But Worm Buddy is just too good not to have. I mean, look at that. Just Worm Buddy, come on now. Come on now. Wow, that exploded midair. 68% deal with the devil. Womp, 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 womp. And I think I will take that Forget Me Now ride Didn't get a devil deal here, which we definitely should have, game. Okay, so let's try this again. So we're not necessarily ahead of the curve now in terms of time for a boss rush, since we are redoing a floor. Oh wow, Gimpy gave us a soul heart there. It's instantaneous, gave us a soul heart as we were picking up that black heart. Worm buddy, look at the big time plays. Endless Nameless. It is a good trinket, but not good enough for me to replace with the Blessed Penny. Blessed Penny is just super duper good. Speaking of super duper good, a Thame, man. Look at a Thame just creating havoc. What a way to start off the week here. Yeah, over the weekend, I spent more time playing Pokemon Scarlet and Violet. And look, you all know that I'm a Pokemon fan, right? If you didn't, I'm a huge Pokemon fan. I love Pokemon. But the technical issues that I have with the game are just... It is an insufferable amount of text, man. Like, and I know they're made for kids. They're not made for man children and you know, grown adults, even though we were kind of the ones who pioneered, like, the popularization of the stage of the franchise back in the day. But, you know, I'm just saying, I get it, right? There's got to be a level of some hand-holding, but good Lord, Nintendo. I mean, it would be forgivable if the game ran smooth as butter too, which it doesn't. It actually runs like demonstrably worse than Sword and Shield does on the Switch. We just need to get an actual next gen Pokemon. Like, I was talking to the stream about this multiple times, and I'm not gonna stick on this subject too much because I know that not everyone likes Pokemon. But one example that I brought up was there's a fantastic game named Temtem. That I haven't really spoke about much on YouTube, but I've played it a lot on stream. Temtem is an MMO, it's a Pokemon MMO, essentially is what it is. It's a Pokemon wannabe MMO. And it is a great example of truly how Pokemon should have been evolving ever since it could, no pun intended. You know, being able to do stuff with your friends freely, you know, mounts, different areas, like large expansive worlds that you can go out and catch. You can catch wild Pokemon without having to see them. Like, I think that's, I don't know why Nintendo seems to be so stuck on this idea that we have to see the Pokemon to know when we're capturing them. Like, the game started out with random encounters. It should just stay like that in the grass. Like, that would help a lot on the Switch's hardware. But no, Temtem doesn't do that. It's all random, you know, it's grass encounters, and it's very simple, and the graphics and music are amazing. And I look at that, I'm like, man, just imagine if Pokemon was doing that. Like, the world would lose their collective minds. I think we take both of these here, Sack Dagger and Juice's freaking Shadow. And, you know, the game runs terribly. It is really, really badly optimized. If it's optimized, they didn't do a good job of it at all. For the Switch, no less. You know, I think that it's just the limitation of the Switch's hardware. And you know, it's not next gen. Like, the first day I played it was on Friday night. And I was talking to the... Or no, it was Thursday night when I was talking to the Mosh Pit. And, you know, I was telling him, I was like, look, I'm not a big graphics guy. Like, look at Isaac. Isaac doesn't have great graphics for, you know, this generation or whatever. Like, I don't care about graphics that much. I play a lot of pixel art games. But I look at Pokemon, and it's like Nintendo 64 era graphics. I'm not even joking. It's really, really, really rough on the eyes. So, you know, on top of that, the game doesn't run well at all. It runs maybe 15 FPS. At times, and everything, all the inputs from like the UI down to the battling system to even like navigating like the world is just, it feels like there's a big delay on it. So, you know, I don't have one of the newer Switches. I have one of the older Switches, so I don't know if that's a problem, but I'm not the only one who's had those kind of complaints. So that was kind of a bummer to the weekend. But overall, though, I mean, I've been having fun gaming. You know, still playing Marvel Snap, still playing a lot of Summoner's War Chronicles, probably more than I should, to be honest. Been having a lot of fun with that game. The Nat 5 rates seem to be way better in Chronicles than they are in Sky Arena. Of course, that's not going to mean anything for those of you who don't play Summoner's War, but yeah. No, it wants to super jump because it's not doing anything. You finally get a tiers upgrade here with Squeezy. Now let's go back and check out our item room. But if you've never given Temtem a go, I highly recommend it. It is a fantastic game. Really, really deep. Really, really good PvP. It's not luck-based or level-based or anything like that. It's straight-up knowledge-based. Like, they go across the board and standardize all stats. So it's all about knowledge of your not Pokemon. You know, they're called Tems, but there's guilds. Like, I have a guild that I run on the server. It's open. It's MMO. It's like, you know, you see other tamers all the time running around and stuff. There's vehicles and all sorts of fun stuff. It's a great game. Big room should be over here. Yeah. Still making decent pace for the secret room. Get a Joker card, eh? Joker. And this will give us a tiers up and spectral tiers. So really happy that I say it every time so far since the new patch, but like. It's such a great change to see Ouija board get a stat other than just a tier effect. Like, it's really, really solid. You might be asking yourself, when are we going to turn into Black Judas? Well, there's two ways we can handle. We can either go the save it for insurance route, or we can hedge our bets, turn into Black Judas on like a devil deal, and then go from there. Our stats are very good right now. Our damage is starting to fall off a little bit, I will admit. But our tier effects are fantastic. Spectral and Athame is just that's like Thanksgiving turkey before. Out of the oven? I don't know where I was going with that. In fact, my favorite part of the turkey and of Thanksgiving in general is like right as soon as the turkey comes out of the oven, and Mama Victa lets me like pick off like the crispy skin, and oh man, I absolutely love it. Turkey skin is just so dang good, just by itself. Like, and I'm a ketchup fan. Like, I usually put ketchup on a lot of stuff, not steak or anything like that. Don't give me any of that crap. I usually put ketchup on fried things, turkey, chicken, you know, all that kind of stuff. Even like mozzarella sticks, like I like using ketchup for those. But there's something incredible about the taste of just fresh, oven baked, super crispy, golden brown turkey skin. It is incredible. And you know, that I just love it. I'm so looking forward to Thanksgiving. You know, 2022 has been a rough year on a lot of people, and Mama Victa's looking forward to it. I'm still waiting for the day. I haven't gotten the full send to allow me to do Thanksgiving in my house. We did it 1 year, the very first year that I moved in to the house back in 2020, and it was unfortunately sullied by the fact that that my aunt had passed away I can't believe I'm forgetting the name of the disease. MDA, is that what it is? It's a horrible disease. Basically, you're trapped in your own body, you can't move, but you're conscious, but it's terrible. Anyway, she passed away from that, unfortunately. And that prevented us from having a full family get together at my house that year. So I never really got to have a full Thanksgiving at my house yet. I wanted to do it this year, but Mama Victa, there was a COVID scare, so we couldn't do it this year, unfortunately. Maybe next year. Hopefully next year. Purple fires only shoot once, so once it fires once, you don't have to worry about it anymore. It's the demon fires, the orange fires, you got to worry about. Great block there by Worm Buddy. Look at that. Kicking off a Thame as well. I tell you what. Feeling lucky. Spending a little bit too much time. We're still able to get to boss rush, but it's getting up against it now. We got to get a move on here. Now, another thing that we could do is we could turn into Black Judas by way of the sack altar, which is a little bit riskier. That's definitely more of an aggressive play. A recreep. I wanted to get in there, get as much damage as we could with a sack dagger. Excuse me? That spider spawn on top of us? Get Worm Buddy, go. We get Glass Eye, which is going to give us damage and luck. We'll get a non-Devil Deal, Devil Deal, which gives us at least back our two Soul Hearts. Got to get a move on here. Curse of Blind, of course, is going to ruin our boss rush choice, so there's no rushing anymore, unfortunately. Yeah, look at a Thame is just self-perpetuating damage. It just takes care of itself, man. Their full card. Loving our shot speed, too. We have a great combination of fantastic tiers and good shot speed. Again, our damage, our raw damage is nothing to sneeze at here. And I'm not going to tempt the meme of the day today because I don't want to get Epic Fetus ever again. I honestly really, truly hate that item. Now, say what you will about my love for Maw of the Void and Brimstone and Mom's Knife and Spirit Sword, you know, all the quote boring items, but like Epic Fetus is, to me, is legit boring. It's a good item, like it is the very definition of hard carry item. It bores the absolute hell out of me. Very interesting map we've got here. From Buddy, I think grab Chubb there. To where we can really take advantage of us having spectral tears, stay out of range of the turret while also keeping our distance from the Globins. Probably going to be a greed fight if I had to imagine. Now we gotta check the shop. Jar and restock. Well, at least restock will allow us to buy a few soul hearts extra. Runs out of usefulness here. So again, I don't mind missing boss rush here. It's Curse the Blind. It just ruins it. It just ruins your day. Everybody making the big time plays there. Look at that. Mobilizing Mom's Foot, giving us total control of the uptime. Oh my god, a Thame. Go negative here. And it's going to be a Krampus fight, which honestly is fine because it's Curse of Blind again, so whatever. Hopefully it's Lump of Coal. That will be huge for us. It's not. Got a Krampus. It's better than the jar, so we'll take it. Yeah, MDS was the name of the syndrome I was thinking of. had to look it up. Felt embarrassed that I've gotten the abbreviation for it. Judgment. Yeah, it's probably not going to make a difference. I'd rather just bomb it now. And the nice thing about Blessed Penny here is that it also, again, helps us recover Black Judas's health as well. So, I mean, soul hearts are totally ubiquitous across any Isaac character, except for the Lost, obviously, where you're always going to get usefulness out of them. Take a little bit of damage there. It's all right. Dead end. This would constitute one of those items, one of those rooms that Sinvicta does not care about, although we've already taken damage and have now cleared it, so I guess it doesn't matter now. Get our soul heart back. We can take it. Alright, let's go to the real side of the map now. Alright, so we got the freeze there from Mom's contact and then Mom's eye, and then immediately Worm Buddy going in for the snipe. Love to see it. Still on a Marvel kick for the last couple weeks. Ever since really playing Snap, I've been on a Marvel kick. And I'm not a comic book fan. Like, I enjoy the art and stuff, but, like, I've never read comics. Really, the first time that I was even close to being interested in comics was when I was playing Marvel Heroes with TB, Total Biscuit. And he introduced me to that game, and I was like, oh my god, this game is incredible. It's like an ARPG, but like a bunch of Marvel characters and X-Men. Like I used to watch the X-Men as a kid back in the day when it was like, you know, it was a cartoon. Like, I used to enjoy that. But I was never into comics. And I was always bigger into, like, Star Wars and stuff. So, you know, lately I've been like, yeah, you know, maybe I recognize all these characters that I'm seeing in Snap and everything, but maybe I should, like, actually watch the movies, maybe? MDA, not MDS. MDA. That is the disease that my aunt had and passed away from. Sorry for the second correction there, but I was like, MDS doesn't sound right. MDA. MDA. That is the muscular disease that she was really unfortunately afflicted with. Anyway. So I was like, you know, the only Marvel movie, and don't judge me. Don't judge me, even though I know you're going to. Only Marvel movies that I've seen was I saw the original X-Men when it came out, the one with Hugh Jackman and Patrick Stewart and Ian McKellen and that one. And then I saw the first Iron Man, and that was it. Those are the only two Marvel movies that I've seen. I think I've seen part of Iron Man 2, but like I don't remember any of it. So, and I think I watched part of the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man, and that was it as well. So what I'm getting at is that, like, I really want to get caught up on, like, Marvel. Like, I mean, I know about, like, Thanos and all that stuff, but, like, I never seen any of the movies. So all the memes and stuff that I've seen, that's the only exposure that I've had to the Guardians of the Galaxy movies or the Avengers or anything like that. So, you know, and I know that people kind of differ on what order you should watch them in, but I want to see if there's a general consensus, because I know the Mosh Pit won't steer me wrong, of like what order should I watch if I'm having, like, I'm gonna have to watch the original Iron Man again because I don't remember it. I don't remember anything that happened in it. What is the quote proper order that I should be watching these movies in? So we're gonna play that a little bit more, but oh well. Because, like, I don't even know if, like, I don't even know if the X-Men movie is even relevant. Like, is Patrick Stewart in any of the new Marvel movies? I don't know. I'm totally clueless. But I want to learn, though. And I definitely want to get to Venom, because Venom is still my favorite Marvel character, even though I know almost nothing about the lore of Venom. I've always kind of liked Carnage, too, to a certain degree, but Venom was always the coolest in my mind. That's who I played as in Marvel Heroes Omega, when it turned into Omega. Me and TB used to play hours of that game. In fact, I think that you can still find a video of me and TB playing Marvel Heroes back in, like, 2016 on YouTube. If you just YouTube Total Biscuit Marvel Heroes, like, you're bound to find it. We used to play a lot of games together. I miss having that. I don't really have like a true blue gaming friend anymore. We're just like not recording videos or streaming together, just playing games together, just shooting the crap, talking about life and stuff. Me and TB used to do that all the time. We used to play Warframe together, as most people know. Marvel Heroes, we played a lot of. Definitely miss my friend. That Fallen was dead, but apparently not. Gimpy bails us out yet again. Saw him doing the brimstone. Yep. You gotta be careful. The hands have lately been getting us hit. Look at Worm Buddy completely stopping Stanley. Whoa, why did you appear behind us there, Stan? That's a nifty little move there. Okay. I've never seen him do that. Usually he appears right in front of Isaac. It's usually you can manipulate the positioning of Satan's feet by moving backwards, and then he appears in front of you, not behind you. A little bit strange there. Contract below, absolutely. Yeah, you know what, Headless Baby, you all right. You all right. I was impressed with you the other day. You all right. Even though you can't hit, targets that are in the air, obviously. That's not your fault. What is your fault is putting down creep on top of other creep that I can't tell which creep is my creep. Gonna get to fight more headless or more famine, I guess. From Buddy snapping Famine's head back and off. Big time of Thame plays there. Definitely seeing an uptick in the amount of incoming damage we're taking, obviously because of our lack of movement speed, thanks to us taking lard. I can't really complain. Okay, not sure why he bounced off that way. That was weird. Oh. Well, Kane's Other Eye we can take. Oil Baby, absolutely not. Thame is just wrecking house right now. Yeah, I'd really like to stop getting the triple with aim, because they seem to be bouncing in weird angles here. Worm Buddy and Mom's Eye. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know anything about Thor. I don't know anything about Loki. Ant-Man. Thanos. Like, I don't know anything about any of those. Any of the Guardians, like Star-Lord or Groot. Like, I don't know anything about him. I haven't seen any of those. I really wanted to see the Avengers when it first came out. And then a friend of mine told me, she said, well, you kind of need to see the other movies first before you, like, there's lots of references and that sort of thing. And I kind of took that advice as church and then just never watched them. Because I'm not a big movie guy. Like, I'm really not. I'm more of a TV show sort of, not even really TV anymore. It's more anime than anything. Of course, I'm going back watching The Shield, of course. I still haven't finished season 4 yet. It's fun watching old shows that I used to wait for. It had DVDs of. Ugh. Ugh. Who remembers that technology? God. Probably didn't use Krampus's head in here, but I did anyway. Just gonna have to deal with it, America. So what? I used Krampus's head on a single enemy that was already frozen and also getting CC'd by Worm Buddy. Whatever. Okay. Well, at least that was fun to look at. All right. So there's the south and east side of the map. Now let's go to the actual side of the void. Dark room, wherever the hell we are. Thank you, Kane's other eye, for firing in the opposite direction. Very, very much so confusing me for a second there. Movement speed. I don't even know why. Why did I take lard? I must have thought that I needed the HP at the time, but we really don't. All it's done is just is cause us to take more damage and slow us down. Red Rage is going to help out with that, giving us some movement speed and range upgrade, and then we also get Tomato, going to paint enemies and make them basically be attacked by other enemies. Very useful tier effect, especially when you've got enemies that spawn other enemies, or adds, as we like to call them. Thought about trying old school RuneScape. I tweeted out last week about it. I still haven't done it yet at the time it's recording anyway. I do kind of want to, but like I'm really enthralled with Summoner's War right now. Having fun playing the game, and no one's joined my guild. Like, I made a guild on my server. I told the Mosh Pit about it in Discord, but it's not everyone's cup of tea, and that's fine. Yeah, I play by myself pretty much all the time anyway, so I'm used to it. There we go. So you saw all the homing shots there go after the body, and that's because we painted it Rotten Tomato. Worm Buddy giving Lamb the fits here. And down he goes. Yeah, we'll do a victory lap. Here we go. 1 Quebec Alpha Charlie, 6 Mike, 8 Alpha. We maintained, So you see Multidimensional Baby right now? Once you do a victory lap, the easiest way to get rid of that bug is just to exit the run and then just go right back in. There you go. I gotta do. Don't want the AAA battery yet. I feel like that's the way to the boss. Maybe. Nope. Okay, calm it down there, gentlemen. And a rock there. Ooh, deep pockets. We already have school bag once. Box of friends. Coupon. Oh, man. Free humbling bundle. I know that breaks the... It does break restock, but I wasn't going to buy anything anyway, so. Coupon also gives us free devil deals as well, so. We can end up getting car battery. That's huge. Definitely would like to up our damage a little bit. It's not fantastic. Not going to take acid, baby. Even though that would give us the conjoined transformation. Oh, wait, no, I can't be there. Double red monstro. Good bar of soap. Take that one down. I think we could do alt path today. We haven't done mother in quite a while. Let's try poop, meh. Let's see how the new Athame deals with mother. Athame. Oh my god. Yeah, well, that's a global D6, so we'll wait on that and most likely 100% forget it, but I'll try not to. Contract from below hooking us up fat here with some keys along with humbling bundle. That. We get into the curse room for free here because we have a adjacent secret room. My favorite new indie rock band, by the way. Soul heart here, a soul heart there. Look at that. Look at that. Beautiful. A fantastic start. Definitely a much better start than last Monday's run, that's for sure. Take that. We get another Steam sale here in Keeper's Sack. Oh, baby. My starter deck. You might notice that I'm not using the coupon right now because I actually want to get benefit out of Keeper's Sack. Now we're talking some... We're starting to get up there. Some big boy numbers here. I think we want Speedball here for our second syringe item and also greater movement speed here. And I guess we're just going to get Damocles. Damocles is active along with 9 lives. Coach. Oh, man. And we're going alt path 2. Hang on a second there, Cowboy. You almost forgot about that D6 room, didn't you? Slow your roll there, Charlie. The 4 room is going to be a global D6, which is going to roll all item pedestals on the map. And we get Telepathy for Dummies, which is our first tap for Bookworm, but we're not going to keep it because the Head of Krampus still has its use, and also the coupon, of course, helping us greatly. Damocles showing up again. And I'm fine with it. We have the extra lives, and we're going alt path. Yeah, buddy. There's our mirror. I'd love to get some benefit out of Damocles here. Good job, Fame. Good job, Worm Buddy. Working in tandem together. Love to see it. Obviously, Damocles is going to give us more item pedestals to pick from, and they are... all terrible in here, so we're just gonna just pass on all of that, I guess. Secret room, maybe. Yeah. Oh boy. Oh boy. Well then. It's unfortunate that we didn't go light side here. We're gonna have to switch it up. We're gonna have to switch up to go back to, I say light side, but standard path. If we want to get, if we want to try for an Omega run, we got to get past the Mega Satan block. It's just how it works. And I think I do still have the I do still have that get out of jail free card. So we don't even need to take Angel deals here. We can take a Devil deal still. Take Last Eye. I will take. Actually, we'll take Dad's Last Coin for the luck upgrade. And I know that we have a Thame, but. Perfection, look, we're going to lose perfection no matter what, all right? So we're going to switch it up and go back to the normal run here. Damocles Omega run, is it possible? Never attempted to get a Damocles Omega run. But Damocles did enable us to get this R key, so... Never know. Never know. Now, what are we going to need for an R key for an Omega run? We need one more. We essentially need Death Certificate. Death Certificate or Genesis, and that will almost guarantee another run. Because what we need to do is we need to find another R key. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Or the only other way that we can get around that would be... Oh, wow. We got... This is going to give us conjoined as well with Little Brimmy. The only way that we can get around it is if there is a teleport card that we can get out of the mother fight after we're done beating her and going in, and then getting a sacrifice room in Corpse 2. That's the only other way that this happens with one R key. Black Candle, absolutely welcomed here. I'll take Voodoo Head. Yeah, we'll take Hive Mind. Yeah, we'll take 4.5 volt. Doors box, not worth 25 cents, sorry. A Genesis is less of a guarantee, because obviously, like, you have no control over whether or not you're going to see a death certificate or another R key. It is possible. This is a full character reroll for everything that you've got, but it's less reliable. But we have gotten death certificates and as well as R keys out of Genesis rerolls, so. Oh my goodness, look at this. Take more movement speed here. We've already got spun. You know it's going to be a good day when we're going for an Omega run. They've used that sun card in there, probably. Oh. Gimpy just going ham here. I'm going to hold on to the sun card, obviously. Gimpy is just going crazy with these payouts. I don't know if they adjusted something with, to do with luck. Luck rating and Gimpy payouts, but man, we're... It just proc'd like five times there. And we're not even close to Guppy here. We only have Guppy's... We only have nine lives, so... getting Guppy for an Omega run would be nice. Especially if you get flying. Damocles, by the way, if you did not know, is a single-use active item that will always create a takeable item pedestal whenever you have another item pedestal. So, for example, item rooms. You always have a double item room. You always get a double boss drop by default. If you take Genesis and while also finding Damocles in there and using it, you'll get even crazier item pedestals that will come out and eventually crash the game. I don't recommend using Damocles inside of Genesis if you can help it. Because it is, even though it's hilarious, it still kind of like causes issues, technical issues with the game. I've seen it crash many a time from Genesis Damocles. Dreamcatcher, we have Keeper Sack, or don't we have Keeper Sack? Am I going insane? We have Deep Pockets, I know that. The Keeper Sack is right there. Why are we not getting stats for these? Are they just, you know what? They're probably too cheap. They're probably not even registering on the Sack-o-meter. Okay. The Keeper Sack meter is not, the amount of money that we were spending was not high enough for it to register as a stat. Does that make sense? We'll take another tiers up here as well as damage up. Or at least shot speed up anyway. We're at 13.37 damage on that leet, that uber leet damage. With aim. Getting a little bit hectic to see all the incoming damage here. If he drops a steam sail, yeah, I was going to say, if he drops an item, we are going to get a item pedestal. So it's, and we have school bags, so it's still possible for us to find a death certificate inside of one of the secret rooms here with Damocles. And to my knowledge, I don't think we've taken enemy damage yet. So we're not on a ticking time bomb. So as I was trying to explain with Damocles, if you do take damage while having Damocles, anything that isn't self-inflicted damage, oh my goodness. You will go on like sort of like a hidden a hidden countdown, sort of. And you always have a slight chance to die with every step you take. That is the penalty of taking Damocles. But in my opinion, it's still worth it, depending on where you are at in your run. If you're at the very end of the run, there's no benefit at all, especially if you're not going to be getting any more item rooms. If you're at the very beginning, it kind of depends on your stats and if you already have extra lives or not. Now, if you have extra lives, there's no downside to having Damocles at that point. Zero. So just keep that in mind. PH Dizzle. Spider Mizzle. Nine Vizzle. Piggy Bank Fizzle. No hearts. A whole lot of hearts. Yeah.
Ooh, yeah!
Gaining lots of stats there from Keeper Sack. Alright, made it plenty of time for Boss Rush. Obviously, we need to do Boss Rush if we're going to be doing a bona fide Omega run. E-Bizzle or Quad Shot? We gotta go Quad Shot, right? Get Spider Babby. Now, this is going to be a Thame Athame's playing ground here. And Worm Buddy, too. Look at that. We're just one-shotting things now. Don't really want to stay horizontal of enemies here in the middle like I usually do. Because if you get Bloat or if you get Monster 2, they're going to immediately light you up. Which is, you know, not fun. Same thing goes for Blighted Ovum as well. So stay above or below the boss spawns in this room. Even if you're overpowered, you're still going to get hit. We are firing. This is a nail gun build here. This is insane. This is like a nail shotgun build. This is crazy. Same thing goes with Uriel and, Uriel. Not Uriel, Gabriel. We get shoot to whoop. Book of Secrets. I'm going to take Book of Secrets just because it's going to give us the compass effect eventually. We don't really need the coupon anymore. That looked like Clutch. Did it not? What is Clutch doing up here? Surely that could not have been Clutch, right? It was either Clutch or Monstro 2, and Monstro 2 doesn't appear in Womb. Unless there's someone else I'm not thinking of. Look at a Thame just... go ham. Whoa there, Worm Buddy. Careful now, buddy. We got hit, so we are now on the Damocles clock. Again, it's very hard to tell where shots are coming from at this point. But it doesn't matter if we die. We have 9 lives. We're not going to die by way of Damocles here. Even if we do, it's not the end of the run, so I don't really care. Hermit card. I'm more curious to see who we have showing up in our boss room here. It's Headless Horseman. That looked a lot like Clutch for some reason. I don't know why. Not the one I wanted to take, but we get Pentagram. Okay. We get Bookworm, which is going to give us even more multi-shots here. But we still got to go fight Old Hushy. The only way that Damocles could kind of screw us over a little bit is if we fight Hush and it kills us in the middle of the Hush fight. Then we've got to do Old Hushy with 1 HP. I've done it before, but it's not like I want to do it, you know. There you go. We get ourselves free entrance into the boss trap room along with a compass effect thanks to the Book of Secrets. And yeah, I'll take some damage here. You know what? Just teleport me out. I would love to get flying here, but we are shooting out so many projectiles now. We've got all the multi-shot except for 2020. We've got all the multi-shot passives here. We've got Mutant Spider, Inner Eye, Bookworm. Got a lot of shots, man. Great. And we still have a Thane popping off left and right. Oh, God. Luck upgrade here. 5.97 luck upgrade. That is the reason why it's proccing nonstop. Look at that. No devil deal. No surprise there. We got to go fight old Hushy. Old Hushy. Yeah, the point of going normal side here is that we have to go fight Delirium anyway, if we're gonna try for an Omega run, and that involves us fighting Mega Satan, obviously, which means that we have to get past the Mega Satan block. Because if he ends the run, then that's just it. Then we can't do an Omega run anyway. So basically, it all comes down to getting past the Mega Satan block. Been denied the last two times we went for an Omega run, so we'll see if we get any more help here. Our damage is sucking because of Proptosis, so I need to get closer. There we go. We are chunking him down. Not even Hush's boss armor can help him out with just the sheer amount of shots that we're firing into him. We painted Hush, which is good for us because his ads are going to go after him. But yeah, I mean, even with this, like, we're still chunking them down here. Oh my god, Fame. All right. Down goes old Hushy. No problem at all. Obviously, we can guarantee the Delirium fight, but then we have no way of getting to Mega Satan. So, still going to check the secret rooms here because we need to for a possible death certificate. Here's gaining charges just all over the place here, thanks to 4.5 volt. Maybe we just go in and just blast them. World card. Party time. Excellent. That goes Isaac. No problem at all. Oh, man. Really is a nail gun shotgun build. You can use the Get Out of Jail Free card, which gives us entrance into the golden door. It's going to give us Beelzebub, so we will finally get flying here. And there is the boss fight. So, course of action here is going to be to take down Blue Baby, see if we get a Delirium portal. Doesn't matter if we do or not, because we still have to fight Mega Satan anyway. Now, there's a technique that I have used before, but it feels a little cheesy, where if you kill Mega Satan and teleport out before he gets a chance to end the run, you can do that. I kind of, like, go back and forth whether or not I feel like that's legit or not, because like you have to see Satan die, obviously. So, you know, there's that. Of course, these rules are arbitrary. I mean, I'm the one who came up with the Omega run in the first place, so you know, it's basically down to basically however I make the rules. But I feel like it's more legit if you do it properly without cheesing a teleport or something like that. We get Dead Onion, which is going to be huge for us for piercing shots. As if we needed more benefit here. Oh no, lost soul, buddy. Oh no. Things are just dying before Athame is even done killing its first victim. Look at that.
It's boom, 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 boom.
Yeah, Stanley hasn't gotten off a single attack yet. Now our tears rate is going up and up and up because of Epiphora, so... I don't know what the name proc'd from up there, but it did. Down goes Megastan. We do get a Delirium portal. So, all right. Delirium is a go. And how much you want to bet the one to the top left is going to be Delirium? Thankfully, we got flying. That's going to make things a lot easier on me anyway. And we should try to go for... Okay, never mind. We can still go for boss kills after Delirium. Like, the run doesn't end because we killed Delirium, obviously. No, lost soul, buddy. Oh, no. My God. I'm trying to stay firing in the same direction so we get the benefit of Epiphora here. Just lighten Delirium up. There we go. Down goes Delirium. Delirium down. We can go and we can just go kill at our leisure now. Now, as per the rules of Omega runs, we don't have to clear the void. It's only doing all bosses and all optional bosses, not clear every single level. That would be foolish. But where the benefit lies here is because we still have Damocles active right now, and we might as well take advantage of getting extra items while we can to make the rest of the run even easier on us. Not that we need it, but, you know. Crooked Penny Damocles. We had some fun with Crooked Penny Damocles. Not that long ago, actually. There was a kind of rock back there that we missed. Not there. We could play that Judgment and get another item spawn with Damocles, but I obviously don't really care that much. I do want Little Horn. We're capped on tiers, so okay. 0-2 on Crooked Penny so far. Go all the way down here because this one's going to be the longest to get to. I don't really care about our bone heart, obviously. Oh, God. We'll take Mom's Pearl for even more luck, even though we don't need the range, obviously. Want the luck for Athame. Don't know. Guppy item. Three bosses left. Some big Globins. Oh, that was a weird transition. What was that? That was like a fade transition. That was very odd. Like, we went through the door and it didn't slide like it usually does. Very weird. Come on, Crooked Penny. We want to have at least one good Damocles roll here. Empty Vessel, Booster Pack. I mean, Sty will definitely take. going back here to get a full charge real quick. Just need to hit something, because obviously 4.5 volts is preventing us from getting a full charge after clearing your room. Hey. Okay. Well, take empty vessel. Don't really want any more of the red heart upgrades, to be honest. We'll take Nancy bombs. And we can just rip our key after this. Down goes Daddy. And down goes Damocles. All right. Well, we could go back and pick up all those HP upgrades up there, just so we have a little bit of extra help. But, I mean, we're about to do another full run here without Damocles, so we're probably gonna get more HP, but. Go back and at least grab these over here. I'm tired of picking you up. There we go. Crackjacks. And dinner. Rip it. All right, same seed. One Quebec Alpha Charlie 6 Mike 8 Alpha. So we are now Damocles-less. No. I think about that. So now we got the plan gets a little bit more, just slightly more hectic, because now we have to kind of hope for us to get a teleport inside of either inside of Corpse 2, or we end up getting a death certificate. All of which are possible. A cricket's body plus tech 1. Mm-hmm. So we still have our shotgun build here. It's just, it's no longer nails. It's just tech lasers. Is here. Oh, lost soul buddy. Thank you. The raw liver. Well, a shame that we didn't have Damocles, because that would have been two items that we could have possibly spawned inside of our secret room. 2020 and suplex. We take 2020 here, which is going to give us massive amount of tears. Sun's habit, sure. There you go. Just like that, we are loaded back up on our HP. Oh, God. Fog got clocked. Yuppie's tail, and yeah, we'll take Dark Matter as well for the damage up and fear shot. Obviously, there's no way to go but down from here. And now is when we got to go get the mother pieces, the knife pieces. Thank you, Lost Soul Buddy, for the Book of Virtues. Check them out now. Lost soul buddy, right about now. Compound fracture. We're just trying to crash the game at this point. Let's stop spawning stuff on me. How about that? Hive Mind Infestation 2 doing work for us. Moving box, eh. Am I going crazy, or did we not see a... Did I not fully explore the map up here? Because I didn't see a mirror. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Like, what the heck? All right, we got to find the white fire. It is not in here. button there. Or here. There it is. Oh no, lost soul, buddy. Oh no. I need to be careful that we don't blow up the mirror, obviously. Yo, I'm not going to bother fighting the extra boss at this point because there's no reason to. And plus, obviously, this video is getting extremely long as we are going for an Omega run. But we'll keep things somewhat sensible. We get Guppy as well. Oh, baby. So we get Guppy. Take a Hermit card. I'm pretty sure Wormwood died without even spawning. He is ultra mega levels of dead. Like Cupid's arrow. And we need to be checking all secret rooms here. Just in case if we do find a death certificate. The fact that Athame can proc off of these is just absurd. Look at that, we get another luck up here. Man, oh man. I mean, this is just we're talking pure power here. Remember, we still have Epiphora, which is going to be proccing even more, even with us having Tech 1. So, you know, look out for that. Oh no, lost soul, buddy. Oh no. Take marbles here. Not all, man. If there was one trinket that we would take over having the Blessed Penny, it was going to be Sigil of Baphomet. And then we get Twisted Pear on top of that, as if we needed more shots on the screen. Oh, gosh. This one definitely is going to get a like for me, Ace. That's for sure. If you're enjoying this run, everyone, and you appreciate these longer runs that I don't necessarily have to do, but are always a fun challenge to do, make sure you click that like button. It's the best way to show your thanks and appreciation for the Isaac content here on the channel, which of course I love doing for you all each and every single day. Been doing it since 2014 and never looked back. We'll get the key piece. Second key piece anyway. Far, it doesn't look like that big of a deal. Like a fairly straightforward map here. A little bit more room up here. Yep. Enter that way. Go over here. A little land bridge. A little shortcut. Get down tonight. Get down. Throw a red bomb. Toss it right at mom. Get down tonight. Oh, yeah. They don't need the key for this part. It just makes things a little bit faster. But you can also just use a red bomb there. Just yeet it towards the rocks and just bypass all this crap. There we go. So now our only hope of really getting a getting an Omega run would be to get Chaos. Chaos and then find it in find a death certificate in the store or somewhere. Oh my god, Birthright again. Checkpoint 5, yeah. Take the compass here. I'm going to hold on to Diplopia. I'm not going to hold on to the Omega Penny anymore because we just don't need it. We can actually, because this is the first run, we can actually... Never mind, I just kidding. Take that back. Get Binky here. I should have done that after opening the door, but oh well. My Reflection and Super Bandage. Neither one of them are items I really truly care about here. For me. yeah, I'll take growth hormones. More damage as if we needed it. Man, oh man, we are just walking back ahead of Krampus. I mean, this is just pure domination. We haven't had a run this strong in quite a while. Oh god, and then Lost Soul Buddy gives us Crown of Freaking Light. Definitely gonna take Hallowed Ground here. Let's go back. Search for what's gonna be our. We only have three secret rooms left to go. Might as well check the shop again. Power battery. Yeah, we'll take the battery. I guess we'll take card reading. Not that we need it. BFFs is going to be huge for our damage. Not that we need it. Gear detonator. Champion belt we will take just because hell, why not at this point? Arrow cloth. Temperance, nah. The only thing that we would want there would be a reverse stars card or reverse lovers card so we can use inside of the secret room. Yeah, good luck, Mom. Get an angel deal. Okay. Alright. We're down to corpse. So here's what we need. We need a teleportation card, which we already have. And then we need to have exactly one sacrifice room in Corpse 2. If we get a sacrifice room now, then it's all over. And we've got it. It's in the bag, because then all we got to do is go fight Beastie. Do the victory lap, fight Beastie, bingo, bango, bongo, got yourself an Omega Runo. Yeah, instant deletion there. I mean, we don't even need to take anything, really. And we did not get a sacrifice room, so now it comes down to the secret room. No reroll pedestal, no Omega run gonna be this time around, unless we find something inside of, I guess, inside of the secret room, super secret room, but highly unlikely there's anything gonna be in there, except maybe Forget Me Now or something. Omega denied once again. It was close. One of these is a reverse. Oh, it's over. Unfortunate. Well, it was still one heck of a run either way, everyone. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, like I said, make sure you click that like button. I love doing these extra inning runs for y'all. I know they're fun to watch, and we got an air of mystery behind them. Are we going to actually complete the Omega run? Not today, but you know what? It was a heck of a good try. And a really good, strong build. So thank you for watching. Like I said, have a great start to your Monday here in the Mosh Pit, everybody. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. Like, thanks to patrons of mine like Christian Baker, Rage God 91, Curse of the Seaweed Seesaw, Matt Long, and John Brennick. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, make sure you check out my Patreon page, which you can find by going over to patreon.com/Sinvicta.